My story animated. So it is finally time to take a look at this channel. You probably don't know about this channel, it's pretty obscure, but we're gonna take a look at one of these videos anyway. In the United States, you can sue anyone for anything. So why not sue a child? Based on true events, but altered to make it more interesting and fun to watch. Okay, so they're just admitting to lying.
Hello, my name is Haley, and I'm 22 years old. Today, I'm going to tell you a story about a very complicated and confusing time in my life.
A time in your life that you can't even remember.
You see, I've never had a normal family experience. My parents split up before I was born and fought endlessly over my surname.
Could you imagine if they just had a whole brawl like this over a name?
My dad sued me when I was a child, which led to an insane trial that lasted from the time I was a few months old until I was 5.
Your dad sued you because of your name? There's no way the court would allow that.
Growing up in that family wasn't easy, and now that I'm in prison...
You were not in prison as a child over our name. There is a lot of things you're not telling in this story. That or this channel is just exaggerating things.
I can see why I've made some choices of mine, especially after my mom told me a secret she had kept from me my whole life about what my dad has done.
And this is all over the way she's named.
But before I continue with my story, hurry up and subscribe to this channel. So she was in the hospital for only a few days while my father was trying to reach her.
She's in the hospital now, huh?
When she got back home, she found him waiting for her there. Mom called the cops and had my father removed from the house. A few months later, my father sued to have my name changed. The thing was, he didn't sue my mom, he sued me.
Why does a dad care so much about that? You can legally change it without courts, right?
My mom had to dress me up and take me to all sorts of trials when I was only a few months old. The process was stretched out for so long and was all over the news.
Wait, was it? Hang on a second. Father sues his daughter over her name. Yeah, I'm not seeing shit. Only these three.
Thanks to my father's lawyers, the trials went on for years, and they were anything but civil. The public was fascinated by our family drama.
Which doesn't exist.
And by the end of the first year, protests started to form outside of the courthouse.
Yeah, I'm sure it's not that deep.
And sometimes outside our home. As you can imagine, this was not a great way to grow up. The trials finally ended when I was 5 years old, when the judge yelled out, "Enough is enough. I will not let this go on any longer."
I'm surprised that lasted 5 years.
He declared that I could choose my last name, as I was old enough to speak for myself now.
Which should have happened in the first place. Oh yeah, she can't speak. But there's no way a case about a last name should last more than 5 years. Or more than one court hearing.
It was a nice thought, but now I wish he let an adult help me instead, because I chose the last name, Glitter Pony.
They could have used one of the parents' last names, but no.
Going through high school as Haley Glitter Pony wasn't easy.
I'm sure by then you would have been able to legally change it.
I was always the brunt of the jokes. I had a few friends, but not many, and they didn't stick around.
Yeah, who wants to be friends with Glitter Pony over there?
My mom and I moved around a lot, trying to get away from our past.
But why? You couldn't just remodel your house?
The more we moved, though, the harder it was for my mom to get a job.
Online stuff exists, you know. Just saying.
She started to blame me for it, and we fought all the time. We lived in a new city every year, sometimes two a year.
I can't imagine you to be rich enough to do that.
And she always threw it in my face. By the time I was in high school, she had to work two or three jobs to support us.
Yeah, that's kind of what you gotta do if you want to move to different cities every year.
She left well before I was up in the morning and came home extremely late at night, exhausted and cranky. I'd ask her how her day was, and she'd always respond with some level of disdain. Most commonly, "I used to be a nurse before you and your drama came along."
She was a baby. She couldn't control any of that.
I would do my best to sit in silence or leave the room, but once she was in her room with her TV on, I snuck out.
McCravings.
One day, I met some people my age in an alley hanging out. I was entertaining enough to have earned their attention, even if it was only for the time being. They invited me to a job with them. They said they had to keep it vague so as not to incriminate me.
They're gonna rob a bank, aren't they?
We went to a jewelry shop just around the corner, not even a block away. They handed me a rock.
I'm pretty sure the windows will be strong enough to handle a rock. It's a jewelry store. Okay, this video is so drawn out, I'm cutting a lot of things out.
Here's the plan. You throw that rock in the window of the shop at the end of this street. It's going to set off an alarm. You run down the street and meet us in the alley on the right three blocks down. I had never done something illegal like that before, but it sounded so exciting. I ran to the end of the street and identified the shop they were talking about. I looked around and made sure the coast was clear before doing the job assigned to me.
Except there's one thing watching you, security cameras.
I looked at the rock in my hand and then through the window of the shop. I felt bad about it, but I excused it by saying they probably had insurance and the owners were probably abusive to their employees anyway.
Or it's a diamond store. They can afford a broken window.
No one's innocent, right? What are you waiting for? I heard coming from down the street. It was now or never. I threw the rock and a piercing alarm began to sound. I ran faster than I've ever run before.
What does this have to do with being sued over her name?
I did my best to count the blocks so I knew I was in the right alley. But my heart was pounding so fast and I was so full of adrenaline that I couldn't think straight. I stopped in the first alley I found, careful to crouch down behind anything I could find and keep to the shadows. I hid there for about 5 more minutes before I saw the leader of the group run past the alley. I decided that it was better to just stay where I was and lie low until I could get back home undetected. When I got home, there were only a few hours left before I would have to get ready for school. I was too amped up on adrenaline to sleep. So I just laid in my bed, vibrating with the excitement of what I had just done.
You just broke a window, relax.
My mom never noticed I was gone, and I saw the start of a beautiful, beautiful thing. I snuck out every night after that, and I got better at it the longer I did it. I had a system. I tried not to get involved in group activities like the first night. That was a rookie mistake. Some nights, I just wandered the streets to see if I could find anything better than the prison that was my house.
This video is supposed to be about getting sued over your name, Glitter Pony. How about you talk about that instead of your life of crime?
Sometimes I'd find new people to chat with, mostly groups of homeless people, and I would often put on a new persona each night. No one could recognize me in the dark, which was something that I liked. One night, someone did recognize me though, and it caused me to break all of my rules. I wasn't expecting to ever come across him again, but once I did, there was no getting out of it.
It's the guy you went to break a window with, isn't it?
I took a deep breath and picked up my pace, trying not to panic. I couldn't possibly imagine who might be following me.
So, why don't you turn around?
You don't know my name, but we met a few weeks ago, he sighed. I handed you a rock. I was confused for a minute before it hit me. This was the ringleader of the robbery on my first night sneaking out. But how did he find me?
I don't know, it could have to do with the fact that you both live in the same city. But you couldn't possibly figure that out, Glitter Pony.
Look, I just need enough money to bail my friends out, that's all. Without my crew, there's no chance in hell I'll get enough. If you don't join them there first, I said with a little more sass than I had intended. Hey, I have to try, don't I? I respected his loyalty to his friends, but I didn't think his plan could ever work.
This is not interesting.
I followed him down the street to the store he intended to rob. What do you want me to do? Like last time, I need you to break a couple of windows, then run like hell. I only broke one window and I wasn't too crazy about it. I lied. They've got insurance and all the owners are all major jerks, if that helps.
Walmart?
I took the rocks and sighed deeply. What choice did I have? I confirmed which stores to hit, so I was sure an alarm would sound. I took a deep breath, steadied myself, and ran the fastest I've ever run in my whole life. I took aim as I ran and made sure to throw each rock with enough force to truly break the windows.
Yeah, that's good. But remember when this video was titled, My Dad Sued Me When I Was One? What does this have to do with your dad suing you?
I thought about hiding out and watching to see if he had enough time to get away, but I didn't want to risk it. When I got home, my mom was sitting in the living room waiting on me.
She saw.
She had turned all the lights off and hidden my room so that when I snuck back in the window, I'd think I'd gotten away with it again. As both my feet touched the ground, a light flicked on and my mom appeared. Just where were you all night? I could handle this. Is that any of your business? I asked, trying to sound more confident than I felt.
I'm sure telling your mom you went to break a window would get you in less trouble than what you're doing right now.
I said, is that any of your business? I said with an attitude. I wish I could storm out, but she stood between me and the door, and it was my room.
You have a window.
I do blame you for this attitude and your recent behavior, though. That's for damn sure. You've said that, but you've never once acted like it. Get out of my room, Mom.
Yeah, Mom. Get out of Glitter Pony's room.
It's far too late to pretend like you care now. I ran to my bedroom and slammed the door, collapsing on the bed in a sobbing heap.
I thought you were already in your room.
Later, I heard my mom talking in the other room. I creeped to my door and cracked it open so I could listen in on her conversation. I know, Mom, but I just can't tell her. It's not right. It was bad enough that the trial went on long enough for her to remember it.
Finally, we're back to the actual story. Did she really think I'd care about her life of crime and breaking windows? Oh, no. You broke a window? Oh, you're so bad, Glitter Pony.
I'm not going to let her know that anything could be worse. My heart started beating faster and faster. What could be worse than that? Look, I'm not going to tell her that her father assaulted me. I'm not. She's already traumatized enough. I did my best to keep this away from her as much as possible and let her have a normal childhood.
Well, she had the dream childhood, having a custom last name, Glitter Pony.
I pushed the door closed gently and sunk to the floor. I hugged my knees and started crying harder and harder. How could I have been such a bad daughter? I had to do something for her. I had to get her forgiveness. I made a plan to steal a diamond ring and matching earrings from one of the jewelry stores I had seen the boy rob.
Back to this, I guess.
I knew how to create a distraction for them, where the things were, and the way in and out without getting caught. I had observed it happening enough. The job went off without any complications at all. I conveniently found the boy I previously helped hanging out in the same alley where he was the first night I had seen him. He agreed to be my distraction since I had helped him before. He offered to pull off the job for me, but I didn't trust him to give me the items he had stolen. When I got home, I wrapped the beautiful jewelry I'd gotten in a nice gift box.
Oh, that went on quick.
Since I had stolen them, they weren't in one of the jeweler's boxes, so I dug around my room in the hopes of finding some old ones. I was so excited to give them to my mom. I knew they would make her so happy and that she would forgive me instantly.
But then she would question how you even got those.
When I got home that night, I gave her the jewelry I had stolen for her, and her reaction was even better than I had hoped. Her eyes teared up immediately, and she gave me the biggest hug she ever had. Oh, honey, how could you ever afford these? This is so unbelievably sweet. You did not have to do this. I found a good deal. Don't worry about it, Mom.
Yeah, don't worry, Mother, with a normal last name.
That night, we watched our favorite movie and ordered a delicious dinner. We stayed up until the early hours of the morning talking and laughing at silly movies. The next afternoon, we were woken up by a pounding on the door.
Police, open up.
Glitter Pony got caught.
Mom rushed to the door, having no idea what was going on. My heart started to pound. I was certain that the jig was up and I had been caught. There must have been a security camera somewhere, I thought.
I mean, there definitely is.
And now I was busted. When my mom answered the door in the jewelry I had taken for her, the police immediately arrested her.
They wouldn't ask her about the earrings first. They just immediately assume they're stolen. Cricket cops.
They told me that she had stolen the jewelry and that I would have to go live with my father. I was supposed to be waiting on an agent to come take me to my father. I ran away. I ran to the prison to see my mother, to confess and ask her what to do. She told me she knew about everything, but she wasn't going to tell the police. She held back tears as she told me to run and lay low.
She gets immediately thrown to prison without a trial or anything. Wow.
I sighed. I knew what I had to do. I went to the police and confessed everything. This was too much, Haley. I just wanted a normal life for you.
Ah, imagine how she's gonna be treated in a prison if the prisoners know her last name is Glitter Pony.
Any new adventure I need can be found talking to the people around me.
And that was my story animated. This was not interesting to watch at all. It was way too drawn out. Like the amount of shit I had to cut out. That's how long this video was. Anyway, I hope you like this video. Make sure to comment, like, and subscribe for more videos like this. Alright, see ya.